Nation. Jordan Moore, Sean Cody, and Max Brown joined now. Lincoln Riley called him out in the press conference today. Matt Leinart.
Big show.
The Heisman winning QB, Fox Big Noon kickoff. Matt, I'm sure you're as happy as everybody else is today. I just want to know sort of your first reaction. You know, we have Bruce Feldman coming up next, so I'm sure you had lots of people that you knew and you were maybe a step ahead of the game, but just your first reaction when you believed that this was really going to happen.
Well, first of all, what's up, boys? Good to hear your guys' voice. It's a good day, man. It's a good day to be a Trojan. It's something that our university has needed in a long time. I think I was probably as shocked as everybody. You know, I'm a little bit in the loop, and you got my buddy Bruce coming on after, and Bruce and I talk a lot, and I think this thing kind of, I don't want to say it was last minute. I'm sure there was mutual interest there for a while now, but I think it came together pretty quickly, and so when I found out, I was pretty surprised, but man, I couldn't believe it. I just said, wow, this is exactly what we need to turn the program around, change the culture, get people excited about USC football again, fill the stands, get the city excited. And Lincoln's the man. And I've had a chance to cover him over the years, working at Fox and covering Oklahoma. So I've, spent a little bit of time with him, and he's a perfect fit for what I think we need and where we need to go. So, man, I'm thrilled. I can't wait.
Matt, I didn't know. I didn't realize how chummy you and the president of the university were, Carol Folch. You threw your name quite a bit around there, man. Are you guys buds?
He's got the in.
I didn't know that. You guys hang out a bunch, or?
So, we go to dinner every once in a while, Sean. I will say this, guys, like, in all seriousness, so, like, I'm listening to that press conference, and you all know as much as I do, the leadership over the last handful of years is just, it's put USC in a different direction. And I had a chance early on when Mike got hired and President Folk got hired and Brandon Sosna, who I speak with often, is a great guy, man, and super talented in what he does. Had a chance to talk to them early on in their tenure, and from the first moment I met all three of them, it just felt different. Now, they hadn't done anything yet, but Sean, it reminded me a lot of when Pete, Pete was one of those guys where, like, when he comes in, we're like, all right, who's this guy? But he could sell you anything. He was so energetic and so passionate about the vision he had for USC football. I felt that, like, the moment I met all three, I just felt that they didn't really know what they were getting into, but they're going to turn this program around and make it great again. And that's what happened. And today the whole message was about leadership. Rick Caruso talked about leadership, and it all starts on the top, at the top with President Folt, and just the passion and the energy and the unity that they have together with one vision and one goal and all that. I mean, that's a big reason why, and even Lincoln said that today, that's a big reason why he wanted that job, was because there's a clear vision, and it's to get USC back to national prominence. We're going to give you every resource you need, every resource imaginable to get to that point. And so I felt it for a while now. Obviously, it's been a tough season the last couple of years, and COVID and all that, but I've been telling a lot of people who, and I'm sure you guys get the same thing, what is USC going to do, this and that. I get texts all the time. I said, just be patient, because I believe in this. I believe in the leadership group, and I'll tell you what, they delivered, man. That's for sure.
Matt, you mentioned Pete, and I know both you and Sean were there in the early days of Pete changing the culture and changing the narrative of USC. What are some of those elements that maybe Pete did early on to change the culture that Lincoln might be able to do in his own way, own specific verbiage, to get this culture back on track?
Yeah, I mean, well, I think with Lincoln, first of all, he's got, he's just got instant credibility. I mean, he's been doing this. He's young, but gosh, he had major success at Oklahoma, 3 playoff berths. He's won multiple championships there, Heisman winners, NFL guys. I mean, that's a perennial top 5 team over the last 5 years. So he walks in with that instant credibility and an understanding of whatever he's going to tell me, I know he's saying something right, because he's had that success. But the message that he said today that Pete was really good at was, it's team first. It's not about an individual player. And we had a lot of stars on our team. Sean knows, of both sides of the ball, but man, like we just played so well as a team because we all bought into that environment, that culture, that locker room, and it was always bigger than us because we wanted to win a championship. And then, you know, all of those accolades happen, and that's what happens. But that's what Pete was able to do, and that's what Lincoln will do. You know, this guy knows how to build a team. He's a heck of a recruiter. I think it's going to be really exciting to watch him recruit this area in Southern California and keep all of those big time players home because all those guys have been leaving. So, accountability, trust in each other, all of those things. And that's something that's been missing at USC. There's been zero accountability in all directions, coaches, players, for players. You got to understand that symbol you wear on your chest, that uniform you wear, what you represent. And I think Lincoln and that staff will buy into what USC is. And that's why I'm excited. Like, I just think this is as good as it gets. And I'm telling you, we're back. SC football is back. There's no doubt about it.
You're listening to Heisman Trophy winner Matt Leinart. One last one for you, Matt. This offense, man, how would you like to play in it?
Well, I wouldn't fit it too well because I can't run.
No Kyler Murray and you, buddy.
I feel you, Matt.
Yeah, Max is worried. Yeah, you guys are getting retired now.
Sean knows with those old knee braces I used to wear, I wasn't getting too far.
Look,
but
stank out there.
but you know what? I mean, this offense is so fun to watch. He is so good schematically, and I would say he and Ryan Day are probably the two best in college football at just what you have, your talent, your personnel scheme, and creating those mismatches. And he's been so good. Again, I've had a chance to really watch his offenses over the years, and he's adapted to all sorts of different types of quarterbacks. Obviously, Spencer Rattler, it didn't work out, but he had a tremendous success last year, and he wasn't the runner. Kyler was special. Baker was his own person. Jalen Hurts was an incredible talent, and now he had Caleb Williams. So there's no doubt that he's going to get those guys to USC. He's going to get big-time skill players. They're going to be really good up front. Oklahoma's offensive line of the year has been one of the best in the country. They run the ball very, very well. It's different. It's going to be a completely different offense. And then just defensively, I love Alex Grinch. And Sean, I'm sure you'll get a chance to get to know him. But he's done a really good job there. You know, it's tough to play defense in that conference at times, but he's done a really good job. And I think with the resources and the recruiting bed that he's about to enter, he's gonna make sure U.S. defense is back to when we were playing, when Sean was leading those boys and we were one of the best defenses in the country.
Oh, Matt, you're too nice. I just had one last comment for you, buddy. You look great on those commercials, man. The acting skills are taking flight. Let's just drop the football work and dive into acting, man. I'm for the Matt Leinart acting experience.
Hey man, you want to be my agent? I'll give you, what do you want, 15%? Let's
35%.
What about his stuntman? Sean will be your stuntman. I think that's
double.
A perfect role
I could
for
be
him.
His double. I got the stubble.
Hey, but Sean, by the way, Sean could be an actor. We know,
no
we know his personality.
That's no question. He was up there telling jokes today. It was perfect for him. All right, hey, that's Matt Leinart. You can catch him, of course, this week in the Fox Big Noon Kickoff. The Trojans are on Fox this week. That one extra game against Cal coming up this week on Matt's network, 8 p.m. kick for us. Thank you, Matt Leinart, as always. Great to see you today, and looking forward to seeing you around the program as much as possible going forward. You teased our next segment for that CEO or TV Pro. You already teased our next segment. Bruce Feldman, your buddy, Fox Sports is coming up next on Trojans Live.